everybody, and welcome back to He Works Hard for the Honey. I feel like we haven't had some content in a little while, and unfortunately, as it got really hot in August and September, my camera just couldn't handle the heat. So I actually thought I was taping a lot more content than actually made it to the website. I apologize for that. I wanted to make sure that we got what's going on today, because there's some exciting stuff happening. First, we're gonna check the honey boxes. The last time I was in there, there was comb built, as well as some nectar in the wax. So, with the new feeding boxes, I'm hoping that we've given them enough resources that they've kind of filled that up. And secondly, I've talked a bit this year about varroa mites. As we're starting to get these guys ready for winter, we're going to be doing varroa treatment, which is about 100 milliliters of grain alcohol in a fogger with about 2 tablespoons of oxalic acid, which is a fairly natural compound. It's what gives spinach its sort of bitter taste. We're going to mix that up into a fogger, and we're going to fog these guys. We're going to do this 3 weeks in a row because varroa sort of feed off the larva. And so if we're continuously over the course of the next 21 days, every 7 days, hitting the hive with this treatment, as the bees sort of go from larva to bees, we'll be hitting any new varroa that sort of have hatched with the bees in the course of that time, really drastically reducing the mite counts as we're getting ready to winterize them, where we'll have pretty little opportunity to get in there and do this kind of work. Thanks for joining me, and we're going to start in one moment with the hive here. Hey everybody, thanks for sticking with us. It's Chris from He Works Hard for the Honey. I hope you guys won't blame me, but since shooting that sort of opening video, I took a sneak peek. I couldn't help myself, and although they are not fully filled frames, I am beyond excited to report that we have not only nectar in there, but some capped honey. And this is the really dark stuff that you can expect at the end of the summer and the beginning of fall. The dark honey tends to be more nutritious, a little more flavorful, and this is what they are putting together to sustain themselves through the long winter that's coming. And we have a few frames that look just like that. And I'm hoping in the next 2 to 3 weeks before I fully winterize and lock down the hives, that we'll have some fully full frames of capped honey. And you may be able to hear that buzzing. They are not happy when you start taking their honey out of the hive, if you can imagine. But it looks fantastic. I am so excited. We are going to have a honey harvest this year. For sure. At least something. And I know that we have a few contest winners who are due. So I'm really looking forward to be able to fill those contest winners' prizes. And now, so what we saw in Hive 1, and if you've been keeping up, we've been going through here and really having to work hard to get rid of extra queen cells. They had filled their space and they were looking to expand into at this point in the year, that sort of instinct to swarm should be gone. We want to make sure of that because it's bad for the original colony and it's bad for the new colony to have a swarm at this point, this late in the season, because the new colony that goes out is not going to have time to find the resources it needs to sustain itself through the winter. And for the original colony, it really depletes their population. It makes it difficult for them to sort of recover in time to have enough of a population to keep themselves warm during the winter. So I'm gonna do one more sweep through here. Collection was last year around this time. They got a little ornery. Because they have to really lock down this corner a while. Oh no, what we're actually have is they've connected wax to the frames. And kind of connected this, which is kind of what bees will do with any open space. So we're gonna have to side to side with this. Alright, now we're gonna make a breeze through. We're gonna make sure that everything looks healthy. And before ramping up and doing the oxalic acid treatment that I was talking about, we're gonna put a little bit of cardboard between the honey box and the brood boxes. Boy, it really has been a few weeks since I've been out here. They've done a good job of really nailing this down and connecting it to the wall. What we also saw around this time last year, holy smokes, was just a much larger collection of resources, which is very consistent with what we're doing seeing right now. Yeah, and they already want me out. So I'm going to throw up a little smoke. A little more than I already had up there. Kind of gets rid of my mammal smell and their sort of emergency pheromones. It's been pointed out to me recently that I've been maybe mispronouncing pheromones. Or pheromones, or just whatever. I'm actually hoping, now that I've mentioned that, Marilyn, who was my junior high. Oh, I see the queen. And she looks glorious. All right, again, a lot of honey and resources. I'm gonna be very careful as I'm putting her back. You got me right on the fingertip. Son of a gun. And Actually, it's a little trick I've been taught that if I stick that under the smoke and kind of rub the smoke in, that will potentially, at least for a little while, get rid of the emergency smells that kind of come with being stung. And it is, in my estimation, looking pretty healthy in here. So I'm gonna try to space this out as best I can. I've seen a healthy queen. Looks like there are a great deal of resources in the hive. And that we are at least somewhat ready for winter to be coming. And I have to be careful. I've actually gotten stung through my veil here at times when it's bunched up. All right, I'm gonna take a moment and scrape some of the wax off of the queen excluder. I missed. Alright, we can kind of edit this part right out as it's taking a bit longer than I had realized it was going to. Wiggle on there to put the queen excluder back. We want to I hardly heard any crunch there. Which, you know, that's the goal. We want to keep a healthy population, and I am so excited that there is wax on every frame here. Which means, if we're lucky, we may get a full box. Which is of course the goal. It's so funny, and as some of you know on Instagram, my personal account is the Boxing Beekeeper. And just like in boxing, there were certain levels that, you know, when I got in, standing on my toes was really hard, and skipping rope was pretty difficult and took some work. And eventually I got really good at those things, and I sort of refer to it as leveling up. You get to the next level of things where, you know, the speed bag's really difficult, and having the stamina to move around the ring and kind of a and then there's a whole nother level of things after that. And I feel like our first season was level one, and I learned how to keep bees, and I did a poor job, but my job at that point was to keep them alive. And even in the experience, though I didn't have a hive survive, I learned such a great deal that this year I believe we're going to keep both hives alive and well through the winter, and that now we've got honey. And so I've leveled up, and I hope learned a great deal this year. About keeping bees that will produce honey. And next year, or most likely over the winter as I'm taking classes, I'm gonna learn how to harvest queen cells, and I'm gonna learn how to make nucleus colonies like the one that I, the two that I bought this year. And how to sell those. And I'm so excited, sort of from where we came almost a year and a half ago to now, that we've got two honey producing colonies in our backyard. It's really, you know, for someone who grew up in Brockton, Massachusetts, I say we've come a long way. Why don't you guys go grab yourself some dark honey, and I'll meet you over at Hive 2. Thanks. Hey everybody, thanks for joining us again back at Hive 2. I'm sorry, not sorry. I'm curious and excitable, and I jumped the gun again. And I am so thrilled that there is at least as much capped honey in Hive 2 as there was in Hive 1. And I'm gonna pull one frame for you to look at. And despite the fact that this colony kind of grew more slowly over the course of the year, I was actually really worried that at some point they might swarm, because my work life has been unmanageable. And I just haven't had the time to get out here and do the maintenance work that I should have been. And that actually may have been a plus, where it just left them to work. Oh my God, that is gorgeous. That is very nearly ready to harvest right there. So what we're gonna be, oh my God, there's a couple of frames that are just fully capped in here. It's, I tell you, it's amazing. It's amazing to see, and it's amazing to think that I worked on a hive in my backyard that is now fully harvesting honey. Some of you will remember Hive 2, and these are not at all genetically related to those, but Hive 2 I got from the same apiary, Swan's Honey, up in Albion, Maine, have connected it all the way through. And last year, the bees I got from swans were really the really, really healthy colony that I had. And this year I got both from them. Had to requeen hive one because they were, I always hate to say that bees are aggressive. I think they're territorial and they're protective of their resources and their queen. Hive one was territorial and protective to the point that it became a problem. And the bees were stinging my poor dog daughter and chasing the beekeeper's wife around the yard. And I had to come out and execute their queen. Ooh. Yeah, in that time, that I've been away, they have really good and nailed this down. I was gonna say, nobody is gonna be happy with me when that pops open. I had expected actually much worse. Oh, and they have actually filled that wax up top with resources. I was especially worried that I just haven't seen as much activity. I was afraid that at some point, unbeknownst to me, they had swarmed. But looking down the frames, that is not at all the case. I am ungodly terrible at keeping the space correct with these frames. So it's looking a little narrow, but I'm actually going to bring you over with me. And let's take a look. Right down there, and you can see there are some a healthy population down there. You can see the honey that they were storing in between over here as well. The queen excluder that I just took off. So it would seem that in my absence, Hive 2 has really flourished. And I'm just gonna pop open a couple of these frames, which are, because, again, I am so terrible with keeping the space. I am assuming that I am going to break open some of these honey cells. There we go. Give me a chance. Because I am so bad at spacing, and they are so good at filling, there is probably a great deal that this is connected to the side wall. Oh, there is a great deal of honey that's about to get capped over here. Ooh, there is a full frame, two full frames, three full frames that I can see. Which means that these bees are ready for winter. Take a look in the middle and just try to see. That there is some, you know, eggs and larvae. This colony obviously has a healthy laying queen. And I do see some room for eggs in there. Nope, that is all honey, and that is all honey. So this is, to an extent, you know, minus the man-made frames and box, what a hive would look like. Completely natural. They would nail everything down and build in hexagons. Starting to let me know that it's time for me to wrap it up, and I'm gonna listen right after I get this frame out. And it looks like this frame had been full. I see some bees chewing their way out. He figured out where to get me. Gee. Smoke up in the air, and I'm gonna put this back together, and we're gonna come back and very quickly do some oxalic acid treatments. And a little bit later, I'm going to come out and put some more food into the feeders. I do want to grab, not only does the beekeeper's wife love using the actual beeswax, but I do have a couple of other local business people who make crafts. There we go. Let's do that. Who are asking for the wax as well? And I think what they're actually going about my hand for is that there's some open honey here that I think they're being trying to be very protective of. And I'm gonna let them do that. We're gonna get the honey super back on and space it out a little bit. Little bit of a crunch there. We're actually doing pretty good here. A little adjustment. We'll throw the inside roof back on. And I am really excited by how well this hive is doing. Given how little attention was paid to it. And that's it. I will sort of include you guys as I get over to the oxalic acid treatments. And if you don't join us there, thanks for watching. And I hope you guys will join us again soon.